Welcome to Great Overload. I'm Anthony, and let's unbox the EVGA Supernova G3. I picked up this power supply, as you guys know, for a little computer that I have for backup and everything else. And I picked this one because the price was so good, and there's a manufacturer rebate on it right now. So it is like $59 right now. And so, great price here in the United States. It's 80 plus gold efficiency. It also has an eco mode, so the fan won't turn on, which is critical for this system because I want it as silent as possible. And so, they got a little bit on a little bit about the eco mode right there, about the fan curves and stuff, I believe it is, and the temperature versus what the fan is going to be at. And that's about it. They kind of go in a little bit of description in the back of what is all on there, as you guys can see there. So I'll let you guys pause it if you want at that point. But, you know, getting some highlights, it's 650 watts, right? And the eco mode, you know, is supposed to be ultra quiet and fan, and it's only 150 millimeters. So it is a little bit smaller than some of these bigger ATX ones that have been out for a little bit. So when you open it up, EVGA has done a great job boxing it. They have, you know, your booklet on what everything is. I was also looking at the 550, but since the 650 was the same price, I was like, I don't really care. They actually have a really nice canvas bag, as you can see here, that you can store all your extra cables in. And so this will be using it. I actually appreciate them labeling it EVGA, because now I can keep them separate. The only thing that would be better is if they actually put the power supply on there. As I get more and more computers, I always like to try to keep them separate. So cable ties, which I'm going to do a build video, but I may not put those in right away. I just want to kind of get it up and running because the other system is on its last leg, so I'll do wiring work afterwards. But then you have a power supply tester, which is always helpful. I always like those. I keep them around because it's very easy if I'm having a problem, and I've done this with other people's computers. Oh, if something's not working right, we throw that on, see if it's a power supply right off the bat. And I've had a few dead power supplies, but we got our Molex there. We got a SATA, Molex 2, actually a floppy, if for people that still use that. I actually have a computer behind me that has a floppy drive in it, so I shouldn't say too much. But your power supply cable, and this is purely modular, which is one thing I was looking for too. I know that there's some downsides. There's screws in there that just fell. So you got your four little screws to mount it, your ATX cable right there, motherboard. So it's got the two ports in, and then to the motherboard side, you have your SATA, and then your CPU, which I don't know if it even needs it on this motherboard. Maybe it does. Then more SATA connectors, and then your VGA, so your GPU side. And then we have the power supply and foam, really nice foam. And then the silica. Do not eat this. It's not good for you. So dispose of that properly. But that's the box there. And then a really nice foam. So it's going to stay well in shipping. I really like the foam that they used on this because it's just how it is. I've looked at packing, you know, from many different computers that I've ordered or parts that I've ordered. And some of it is just, oh man, you wonder how it could even survive in shipping, with considering how some of the UPS and FedEx, depending on your delivery driver, actually ships it. But nice canvas bag, EVGA on it, and then I'll try to do it so it doesn't pick up too much on camera. As you see, the first thing you see is the all the ports, two modular ports there, and then you got a little bit information on that side. Actually, I think it's the same information on both sides, just rotated depending upon which way you put it. Serial number and stuff up on top, EVGA Supernova, and then here's the fan. And if you see in there close enough, they actually put little E's on all the fan blades. I don't know if that does something or whatnot, but if you can, yeah, you can kind of see in there, you can kind of see all the parts. I'm not going to take this apart and do that part of a review, but then you also have the power port there. So you got your on off switch, and then you got your eco mode on and off. So that's pretty cool. And then you can kind of see one thing that they did say on the box is that it uses Japanese capacitors and everything else. And, you know, so it's supposed to be rated very good. I've had very good success with the EVGA. I haven't used them personally here lately. I've been using a lot of Corsair power supplies lately, but I've been using them more in some other builds I've been doing at work, and I really like them. And so I've been buying them. So I decided to buy this one because, heck, it was a great price, and it's gonna basically do. It's way overkill for what I need it for. So I was like, okay, let's take it, and for the price, I'm not gonna complain. But it is a 80 plus gold, and I do appreciate that. So we'll see this, and I'll get a build video up here, or I'll work on a build video, and then I'll get up as soon as I get done, editing it and everything else. So thank you for watching. Let me know if you have any questions about this power supply. Once I get the system together, I'll be sure to test whatever you guys would like on that as well. So leave it in the comments below. And until next time, I want to thank you guys for watching. Thank you for taking the time to help support Grave or Low and helping this channel grow. I really appreciate it. I really like how you guys really help this channel grow. It means a lot to me. And until next time, don't forget to like and subscribe.